What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about opening up some database ports within your environment using group policy. So let's get right into that. All right, so like I said, we are opening up some SQL database ports within the environment, and the reason why is because basically I just created a new database and I want to do everything kind of clean, and I need to open up some ports so other servers are able to use and take advantage of that new database. So within my Active Directory, I'm going to open up my group policy management. Within here, I am going to go inside my group policy objects, and I'm going to right click on group policy objects and then click on new. Let's give our new GPO a new name, and this is what I'm going to give it. And then we are going to click OK. We are going to locate our new GPO, select it, right click on it, and then pick on edit. Within here, we are going to go inside the computer configuration. Within computer configuration, we are going to go inside policies. Within policies, we are going to go inside Windows settings. And within here, we're going to open up security settings. Within security settings, we are going to locate the Windows firewall. And within the Windows Firewall folder, let's click on and expand the Windows Firewall with Advanced Security. Now, we are going to select the inbound rules. We're going to right click on it and then pick on new rule. From the wizard, we are going to pick port. We're going to click next. We're going to leave it as a TCP. And we are going to specify the local ports of the following 1433, 1434, and then 4022. We're going to click next. For the action, we're going to leave it as the default. Click next. For the profile, I'm going to leave it as the default. Click next and then provide it a name and then click finish. Now we did our first rule. Now we have to create three other rules. So do the same process, you know, right click on inbound rules, click on new, and you're going to get this. Now for this one, we are going to do a custom and we're going to click next here. We're going to actually specify a program path, and it's going to be the following. It's pointing to CVC host.exe, and we're going to click on next. You're going to get a warning. Just click yes here. Now for your protocol type, we're going to click on the drop-down menu, and we're going to pick TCP. And for your local port, we're going to click on the drop-down menu, and we're going to pick RPC endpoint mapper. Click next here. Click next here. We're going to allow the connection. Click next here. For the profile, we're going to leave it as the default. So click next. And we're going to give it a name and then click finish. Now, later on in the video, I kind of rearranged the name. So don't freak out if the names are different. But I had to rename everything. So because the next two rules that we are going to create is a distributed transaction coordinator rule. So I just had to rename them so I know in the future what they are. So do it again. We're going to create another inbound rule. We're going to do a custom. We're going to click next here. It's going to be a specific program path. And the path is going to be, again, a CSVC host.exe. And then we're going to click next. You're going to get the warning. Just click yes here. And for the protocol type, we're going to click on the dropdown and we're going to pick TCP again. For the local port, we're going to click on the dropdown and we're going to pick RPC dynamic ports. Click next there. Click next. We're going to allow the connection, so click next. For the profile, I left it as the default. Click next and then provided a name. And then, like I said before, I renamed everything to make it a little easier. When someone comes in, they know what the rules are actually being used for. Now the last one, same thing, right click on the inbound rule, create a new rule. You're going to get the wizard, so click on custom. Next here, we're going to specify a program and the program would be the following, which would be the msdtc.exe. Click next here. Now for the protocol type, we're going to click on the drop down menu again. And we're going to pick TCP. We're going to leave the local port alone. So click next here. Next again. We're going to allow the connection. So click next. The profile, leave it as the default. Click next. And then provide it a name. And then click finish. And then we're done. So we created four rules. which are designed for your Microsoft SQL database to have access. Now, next thing that you need to do is take this group policy and then apply it to an OU that you want your servers to have access to that particular database server, and that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.